The BOTA Tarot Tableau has a number of uses and patterns within it. If one were to seek the central balance point of the tableau, one could look to the power of one through the agency of one. Key 11, the central card of the tableau, where sits Libra, holding the scales of balance, and wherein Saturn is exalted. One pattern is the tale of a fool on his way to Saturn, via keys 1, 2, 3, 4, etc., all the way to key 21, which is Saturn, and wherein any particular key he encounters is the antithesis of the one preceding or proceeding it, and whereby the powers or potencies of the top row work through the agencies of the middle row for the performance of the results of the bottom row. For example, keys 1, 8, 15 are acts of attention repeatedly given to a particular problem, key 15, results in the antithesis, the solution, key 16. And this, our lessons tell us, is the first stage of spiritual unfoldment. Beginning here in key 15, Capricorn, where Saturn rules, and ending in key 21, where Saturn is, dancing the dance of life at the center of the cube of space in Malkuth, in the land of Asia, where to function requires a physical body. On our journey from key 15 to key 21, all bodies come under the purview of key 18, the corporeal intelligence. From this standpoint, we can view the gently undulating path of return from its beginning here at the pond all the way to the mountains in the distance, atop which dances the fool, under the white sunlight of Kether, the crown. The path is one of grace and ease,
joy
and style. Running down from key 4, 11, 18, it adds to 33. 33 is a mystical number. It refers to the union of the 32 paths of wisdom with the one hidden behind the three veils of the absolute. 33, as 3 by 3, are the dimensions of a square of Saturn, like the one to our left here, whose central card is key 9, and whose path of synthesis is keys 1, 9, 17, wherein Saturn again rules. 3 by 3 is the square, 3 by 3 by 3 is the third cube, and the total of 27. The gematria for 27 is an enigma, to distill, to pour down in drops. 33 is the number of the square of Saturn whose central card is key 11 and whose path of synthesis is keys 18, 11, 4. The gematria for 33 is the revelation and the measurement of space. 33 reduced is 6 plus 33 is 39, and that's the number of the square of Saturn to our right, wherein the central card is key 13 and the path of synthesis is keys 19, 13, and 7. The gematria for 39 is God who knows all things. So in seeking to find the balance point of the tableau, we find that it is key 11, or karma, and it's been heavily marked by Saturn. So at this point of our journey on the path of return, here at key 18, it may behoove us to sit down, have a little rest, maybe take a nap, and have a look back on our history of how we got to where we are, where are we, and what can we anticipate on the continuation of our journey to key 21 and cosmic consciousness. And for that, we might take an overview and view it from the standpoint of key 18, which is titled the Moon, but which we know is really Pisces. But we're going to need the moon and the power of memory if we're going to look back on our history. And for that, we know that we need to consult the High Priestess. So at this crossroads, we're going to invite her down, and bringing with her the letter Gimel. Our lessons tell us that the pathway to Kether lies through Gimel. So here she not only brings the letter down, but she spells the word itself by joining up with Lamed, the moon in Libra, to spell Gimel. But this addition of the High Priestess to our path of synthesis changes the number from 33 to 35. And the gematria for 35 is Gaza, royal treasure. The royal treasure that lies within here is the seated cross tableau. So what the seated cross tableau does is it breaks this Saturnalia down into its component parts and segregates them so that we might more readily assess their relationship to our personal karma. So to start with, we'll separate the beginning and the end of the tableau, and then taking further advantage of the powers of Key 18, we'll ask for the power of organization. Organization before we continue on this path, and another thing before we continue, it might be time to get rid of any unwanted baggage. And so for that, we're going to enlist the aid of the twins and their mighty sword of Zane, which cuts away and disposes of anything that stands between us and the attainment of our aim. Further from the standpoint of Pisces, we'll invite down our rulers, Jupiter and Neptune, to lend a hand or a foot, as the case may be. Jupiter has been most instrumental in getting us to where we are now. And where are we now? Well, our lessons tell us that you can see that by the rising red Anubis and the location of his head, indicating where humanity is now. That's about as far as those powers of Key 10 can take us. To the country club where all the stars hang out, the ivory tower condos of Key 18, that's about it. That's about as far as it'll take us. In order to reach the top of the wheel where sits the Sphinx, Anubis must pass through Yod, and then to reach the top. So these are powers that are the opposite of what it's been using and are the very powers of our other ruler, Key 12. The Hanged Man, the Stilled Mind, Samadhi, which will be most useful in reaching Key 21 in cosmic consciousness. But as for the journey of Anubis, as he rises to complete his journey to the top of the wheel, he arrives at the Sphinx. Now, where is the Sphinx? From our vantage point in Key 18, following the path of synthesis, Keys 19, 13, 7, and there we are. There's the Sphinx. So what would it be like if we were to, right now, start off on this path of return? Well, first stops the Sun. So how would we go there in the Sun, dancing around in a land with no color red, using collective consciousness and under the power of nine through the agency of one? Well, to get where we are now, I've already been through nine. I've waved to the hermit after I left the house of the magician on my way to frolic with the sylphs and nymphs in the aerated pool of the Aquarian Country Club where all the stars hang out. That's a fun place. Key 17, the power of seven through the agency of one. So when it comes time to engage with seven and the chariot, at least we can say that we've gotten our feet wet. But how about death? Death may be a problem. Because if we can't get past death, well, then it's back to the birth canal for us and begin all over again. And that's something we'd really not like to do. So what are we facing here? Well, death's got a mighty sharp blade, controlled by a staff of will, and capped by a T-cross of Saturn, which is the same one that's on the breast of justice, our karma. So maybe our karma has something to do with getting past death. And then there's the number 13, the power of three through the agency of one. Well, we know that three is the Empress. And she sits here, and in one hand holds the dove, and in the other hand holds the cross, which is the actual cross of the seated cross tableau, a cross surmounting a circle, just like the one we have here, see? a cross surmounting a circle. And this is the seated cross tableau. Having segregated the Saturnalia into beginning and end, and the paths of synthesis, and the path of the cross itself. So we can meditate on these aspects and see how they relate to our personal karma, noting things like the beginning three cards, 8, 15, 16, total 39, and we know that 39 gematria is God who knows all things. We can look to the last three cards, 14, 21, and 20. They total 55, and the gematria for 55 is Kala, the bride in Malkuth. The cross itself totals 71, a prime number, and the gematria for 71 is the dove, the bird sacred to Venus, being held here in key 3, and the symbol of love, creativity, creative imagination, and reproduction. And so to use the cross, we do as we learned in our lessons, and first put our attention on key 2, our memory, and how it relates to the subject matter, which is key 11, our karma. Having explored that, we can move on to key 3, creative imagination, and clothe our memory with creative imagination to have a look at how we're doing here, where we are now. Now, the Empress, she's married to the Emperor, famous for his logic and reason, and he sits here holding in his left hand the cross of the High Priestess, and in his right, the T-cross of Saturn, which is the same as on the breastplate of justice, and forms the handle of the cross of the scythe that's wielded by death. So if we want to have a little look down the path we're headed for, we can feel free to ask the help of the Emperor. His foresight gives authority and power over circumstances. Next to him is seated the Hierophant and intuition. Now he's got crosses in three worlds. He's got crosses on his hands and feet. Those crosses are the ancient X form of Tav, which was affixed to documents to show that they were legal and binding. And that's why he's in charge of the licensing bureau. And then last, but certainly not least, any light or help from above is always most appreciated. So having had a review of our situation, organized ourselves before the continuation of this journey and gotten rid of any excess baggage, how would we go now if we were to continue on the path of return? Well, the first stop is the sun. And we know that the power or potencies of key 5, the Hierophant, working through our ruler, key 12, Samadhi, produces collective consciousness. So on our first stop, we can expect to experience various forms of mental telepathy, have fun dancing in the sunlight, and maybe even experience a solar tropism. But how are we going to do facing death? What are we looking at here? Well, key 13 is the chief agency of our helper here, key 6. And the magic sword of Zane in key 6 cuts away and disposes of anything that stands between us and the attainment of our aim. And it's this very power of discrimination working through key 13, the imaginative intelligence,
which changes the shape of the sword into the shape of a scythe,
which must still clear away all that stands between you and the attainment of your aim. But rather than cutting away to dispose of, this is more like a harvest. Now, all your good works, what a great ruler you were in your own particular kingdom, your marvelous religious philosophy, the empathy and care you've shown for your fellow man, all of these golden threads of gossamer must be cut away and pared down to the bone until it's white as that white rose of purified desire. Then, the imaginative intelligence will pick and choose from the very best of this harvest to fashion and adorn you in raiment of splendor, more befitting the sun at noon. So you'll be looking good when you stand face to face with God and not dying. Dance the square dance in and out of different dimensions, Twiddle your fingers in the water that does not wet the hand. Touch and response of the first matter. Identification of the seven sounds that facilitate the transition from first matter to second. And more, many more royal treasures of victory are yours in your own personal field of life experience, where you can verify these marvelous revelations so that you might enjoy the state of cosmic consciousness, not just as a flash, but as a permanent state of being. So, are you ready? Are you ready to continue the journey? Well, if so, please note the path is colored yellow, the same color as the dancing shoes of the fool. This is to remind us that the path of return is not to be trodden, but to be danced. And here you stand, just fresh out of the pond of Pisces, barefoot. You don't even have a pair of dancing shoes. You don't even have a dancing shoes license. So for the sake of this tale, from here in after, when referring to you and your journey of the path of return, we might also refer to it as your quest to obtain your dancing shoes. And for that, we have more Gaza, royal treasure. Yep, we have a treasure map. We have a map of the path of return. The map of the path of return is held in the water dance tableau. And the water dance tableau begins with superconsciousness and takes place over all four worlds. Here in the first world of Atsaluth is the seed idea of the water dance. It's the dancing fool in his dancing shoes with his dancing dog in the water caught up in the ice, snow, and glaciers of the mountain, which by the heat of the sun melts and flows down into the valley below, where by the heat of that very same sun it once again rises and through the evaporation breath settles again at the mountaintop of the fool. This process is repeated, and this process is the desire of the pool, his white rose. And this is the one-card water dance tableau in Atsaluth. So if we want to elaborate on this seed idea, we have to go to the world of Bria, where we have superconsciousness through self-consciousness, superconsciousness through subconsciousness. So now we have the water melting from the mountaintop of the fool, flowing through the garden of the magician, and into the ocean of the high priestess, the ice to the ocean. And there by the heat of the sun, it evaporates and flows back through the breath of the magician's garden, and through his two-way wand, rises once again with the aid of Mercury to the mountaintop. And that is our three-card water dance tableau in Bria. So if we want to see all the possibilities of this, if we want to look at every pattern possible in the universe, we have to go to the world of Yetzirah, which is overseen by the Hermit, key 9, and that's the extent of our numerical universe, 0 through 9. And the Hermit is actually the fool, after he's climbed that mountain and exhausted all the possibilities therein. And he stands here now, no more wearing those dancing shoes. He's glided into those soft, comfy slippers, moved his staff to his left hand, and now says, "Anytime you want to look at a pattern, come on by. I got my own light, come day or night." He's seen it all. He's the Ancient of Days. And so now, the water flows from the mountaintop of the fool into the garden of the magician and then into the ocean, where through the evaporative breath it rises and settles on the mountaintop where stands the hermit. And this is the four-card water dance tableau in Yetzirah. But if we want to see the water dance tableau in Asia, the material world, well, he can show us that too. He's got all the patterns. And with the aid of Mercury, who rules, as well as is exalted in Virgo, and so can help us here above on the astral plane, as well as below on the physical plane, we now have the water from the fool melting down and going into the ocean, and then evaporating through the magician's garden, and rising once again to the mountaintop where stands the hermit. And that is 0 plus 2 plus 1 plus 9 is key 12, and the letter Mem, which means water. And here he is, his head suspended in the dry water course, which is the history, or his story, of water. And we can tell by his white hair that he's actually our hero, the Ancient of Days, in his younger days when he still wore his dancing shoes and couldn't keep money in his pocket. But being as he represents Samadhi, he can function on both planes, here on the astral as well as on the physical, but to do so, he requires a cube of space. And a basic one will do, a 3, which is 2 and 1, by 3, another 2 and 1, plus a little creative imagination of another 3 gives us our cube of space here in the material world. And now the water runs from the mountaintop of the Fool down to the ocean, through the evaporation of the Magician's Garden, and then into the Garden of the Empress, where it flows from her south, and then west, and then to below. And she is Kala, the bride in Malkuth. And she's married to our hero, the Ancient of Days. And he loves her dearly. He'll do anything for her. He tells her, "Darling, anything you want. You just cast your desire down that river, and when it flows through my magic cube, out will pop anything you want. Like, look, here's those two crosses you ordered for that seated cross tableau. Now, is there anything else at all, my darling bride, that I can do to make your toes curl?"
"Well, I'm sitting here tapping my toes on the moon. I've been dancing with the stars and Claire de Lune. But if you really want to see these toes curl, watch them dance around the world." "Yeah, they want to dance around the world."
"Right," says the Emperor, casting his gaze upwards. "I'll see to it." And to Mercury he says, "Well, Her Majesty, she wants to dance around the world. Can you show me a way to get this done?" And Mercury says, "Well, I'm not that good a magician. Perhaps we should consult the wise man." So they explain the situation to the Hierophant, and he says, "Well, if Her Majesty wants to dance around the world, she's my ruler, so whatever she wants, she gets. But you, Your Majesty, you're the Emperor. You've got an empire to run. You might want to consider appointing someone else to this task, someone who you feel would be victorious and have Her Majesty's best interests at heart." "Sounds good to me," says the Emperor. "You got anyone in mind?" "Well, as a matter of fact, I do," says the Hierophant. "As you know, I have a penchant for unidentical twins, like these two bald fellows here that keep the pathways cleared in the garden that I share with the magician. Well, this guy, he works with me sometimes down at the licensing bureau and is himself the unidentical twin of the Empress, and so would certainly have her best interests at heart." "Oh," says the Emperor, "him. Well, I certainly do admire his poise, but he races around in that fast chariot and hangs out with some pretty strange-looking women." "True, true," says the Hierophant, "certain and most true. However, considering the scope of this endeavor, we might consider him to adapt that chariot to a four-wheel drive and install a governor therein." "Sounds good to me," says the Emperor. "Let's ask him." So they invite the charioteer in and explain the situation to him. And he says, "Whoa, my sister wants to boogie? You bet, I'm into that. And as far as adapting a chariot to a four-wheel drive, we'll just exalt that on here right now. And then for a governor, how about Karma, as the agency of the Emperor, answering only to him? How'd that be?" "Most impressive," says the Emperor. "So, have you got a plan? You got any ideas?" "Well," says the charioteer, "if Your Majesty will note, that river changes direction a bit when it flows through your cube. Well, when it flows through mine, it's going to have to change direction a lot. Because if my sister wants to dance, she sits in the east, and this river is flowing to the south. So I'm going to have to change the direction of the river. And to do that, we're going to need more water. So first off, I'm going to have to raise the level of the river," he says, adjusting his left water wheel. And then I'm going to ask the help of the twins and their magic sword of Zane to work through their agent so that nothing will be standing between us and the attainment of our aim and the changing of the direction of the river. And it doesn't make any difference who you are. If your mama can't dance and your daddy don't rock and roll, they ain't coming to this party. No dancing shoes for them.
And then I'm going to enlist the aid of those tasty ladies with the body of a lion.
To add some strength and rhythm to Michael, the Archangel of the Sun, as he cleans, cleanses, and purifies those waters, making sure that no devils with their clattery hooves get in and dirty them up, and that all the waters, whether they're coming in from above or whether they're coming in from below, are purified before they enter the ocean, ice to the ocean, where they're met by that absolute genius of water, the Archangel of the Moon, Gabriel, who performs the function of the number zero in the number 20, the number zero, the power of zero through the agency of two, just like we have up here at the beginning. Zero, the fool, through the agency of two, the high priestess. And this is the path of the water in the water dance tableau. From zero to two, to one, the magician, then back over to the empress, and then 4, 7, 13, 14, into the pond, into the ocean. Sandalphon strikes up the band, Gabriel blows his horn, and we dance above, we dance below, we dance around the world. And that is the 22-card water dance tableau in Asia, part one, as told by the Hanged Man
from his vantage point on the astral plane.
But we came here to look for the treasure map, and that is to be found in the world of Asia, the material world. And the Hanged Man can help us there, too, because as Samadhi, he can function on both planes, the astral as well as the physical. And not only that, his letter, Mem, is the water letter of the mother letters. And as we know, water cannot be compressed. So when he comes down into the material world and mirrors the dancing Saturn at the heart of the cube of space, he brings with him the water, which adds the stability necessary for a material world. And now we have all the dancers of Asia lined up here. You can see where he's doing his little Irish jig. And so now it goes where Samadhi, through cosmic consciousness, yields the collective consciousness. Or a flagellant motion meeting an egg results in the splitting of the cell. And that is the first of the unidentical twins. And those cells continue to split until you're born into the world of sound and chucked feet first into the gene pool, where you can paddle around to your heart's content until that day comes when you say, you know, I've been looking at that path for a long time. And I hear there may be dancing shoes in them thar hills. And what the heck, I'm going to give it a go. And the journey of a thousand reincarnations begins with the first step, so away you go, and, well, you're headed in the right direction. The mountain's getting bigger. And you're met here by Isis Uranus in Aquarius, which is ruled by Saturn, shown here as the horizontal leg, and Uranus, shown as the vertical leg. And that's the first and last dances of the deck. So which way do you want to go? First or last? Left or right? Which way is it going to be? So you have a look to your left, and you can see, well, there's a rainbow. There's water and fire. And it looks like these mountains have resolved themselves into two main peaks. It's hard to tell from this distance, but it might be that on top of one is some sort of a Hindu guy with a turban and his arm stuck frozen up in the air, and maybe on the other one is a dancing Sufi guy. But looking to the right, there's five, count them, five senses. And with those, I could just arise and dance and party and dance some more until I can't dance no more, and then go to sleep, and then arise and dance some more, and sleep, arise, dance, sleep, arise, dance, sleep, arise, dance. And these are the three bottom legs of the Tree of Life. So you can do-si-do around here as long as you like. But there comes a time when you say, you know, I think I may have gained a bit in compassion here, and I want to test that out on that other path. So away you go, and what? You got water on your head, and then fire, and then water, and fire, and water, and fire, and what's going on here? Well, you need a good cleaning up. You've been living in that swamp for a long time. You got to wash the hair of that growly old Capricorn devil lion and steam clean the plume of Scorpio desire. Because if you can't bring your devils to heel, well, then there's no way you're getting past death. And if you can't get past death, well, then it's back to the womb tomb of perfection for you, where it may be a moot point, but you'll once again get to view the legs of the dancer. The right leg ending in toes pointing at an X, and the left leg ending in a cloven hoof pointing at fixed earth, where power is integrating. And then it's on to the splitting of the cells, birth into the world of sound, and back into the gene pool. But you know that you keep at this, you will clean your act up. And there'll come the time when it's not a problem to get past Michael. He stands aside willingly and welcomes you and says, bon voyage, on your journey to climb those hills, get to the top, and get those dancing shoes. And as you climb higher and higher, you see that, hey, from this vantage point, up here on the astral plane, what first appeared to be two mountains is actually one. And from now on, you won't be needing all this. All you need is a systematically woven chain of interrelated desires presented to your subconsciousness, who will be happy to provide you with anything you want, provided, of course, that you first cleared the okay of superconsciousness in key 6. So what'll it be? What do you want? You want your dancing shoes. Right, she says, and so in you go to key 6. She presents your request to superconsciousness, who says, well, I've been watching you dance. That's some pretty fancy footwork. So sure, no problem. You can get them shoes. All you need now is a dancing shoes license. So if you'll have a seat in the licensing bureau, the Hierophant who runs the bureau will be with you in a moment. So you go in, you sit down. In comes the Hierophant. He sits down and says, right, dancing shoes license, eh? Well, if you'll cast your attention upon my shoes, you'll see that they're adorned with the glyph of the reconciled, unidentical twins of the horizontal and vertical line. What you can't see is that inside those shoes are 10 more unidentical twins. So if you want to get your dancing shoes license, you got to pass the test. And to pass the test, you have to reconcile all 10 of the unidentical twins. And I think you've got a pretty good shot at it. I like the cut of your jib. Just the look of you is sort of like the antithesis of the problem. And I think I have some exciting news for you. In seeking to verify your application, we find that you've already washed the hair of that growly old Capricorn devil lion. You've brought your devils to heel. So if you just put your left foot down here, we'll fold these edges up, take some measurements, and this will be your left foot dancing shoes license. Now the right foot is taken care of by the Empress's brother. He also takes care of the chariot driver's licenses. And he's mainly concerned with Pisces, because Pisces rules the feet. Now, he don't care whether you want to howl at the moon or not. He just wants to know if you got two left feet. Because if you got two left feet, you can't dance. You probably can't drive a chariot either. So what is it? Two left, left and a right? Left and a right, you say? Well, then welcome to the unidentical twins ball, where you can dance away to your heart's content and nobody can stop you. In fact, if someone would come along and cut your foot off or even cut your head off, with this license, it makes no difference. You just pop right back on up and keep on dancing. And in seeking to verify your application, we find that you've already passed probation on the power of the pecker in the pouch. So if you'll just put your right foot down here, we'll fold these edges up, take some measurements, and this will be your right foot dancing shoes license. And I think you've done such a exemplary job so far that I'm going to throw in a chariot driver's license to boot. Wow, most impressive, says the Hierophant. That means that if now you'll put your attention on my two bold fellows here You'll see that on their backs is the glyph that is now yours. With your dancing shoes, you can either dance that single path of return, or with your chariot driver's license, you can drive it on the split path. It's up to you from now on. You can dance or drive. So if you'll just show the license to the magician, see where I'm pointing? He's reaching down through the garden there. Just show him your license. He'll take it upstairs. And what's this? This is the four-card water dance tableau in Yetzirah, overseen by the hermit. And he says, dancing shoes? No, no, no. Keep going. That's up in the three-card water dance tableau in Bria, where the water from the ocean evaporates through the magician's garden and by the aid of Mercury rises again to the mountaintop of the fool in the one-card water dance tableau in Absalus. And there you are, with your dancing shoes and driver's license. Wow, looks like scintillating times ahead. I'm the adventure of life. I'm the eternal youth. I come from the valleys of yesterday to the exhilarating heights of today. I climb gaily from height to height. I'm the eternal traveler, journeying into the miracle of self-discovery. Never a time that I was not, never a time I will not be. I am sure of foot in adventure with laughter. I am the fire of livingness. The security of attainment is my destiny.
As thick as thumb, it's the end of the road. It's the rest of the stump. It's a little alone. It's a sliver of glass. It is life. It's the sun. It is night. It is death. It's a trap. It's a gun. The oak when it booms, a fox in the brush. The note of the wood, the song of the thrush, the word of the wind, the cliff, a fall, a scratch, a lump, it is nothing at all. It's the wind blowing free, it's the end of a slope. It's a beam, it's a void, it's a hunch, it's a hope. And the riverbank talks of the waters of March. It's the end of a strain, it's the joy in your heart. The ground, the flesh and the bone, the beat of the road, a slingshot stone, a truckload of bricks in the soft morning light, the shot of the gun in the dead of the night, a mile, a mast, a thrust, a bump, it's a girl, it's a rhyme, it's a cold, it's the mumps, the plan of the house, the body in bed, and the car that got stuck, it's the mud, a flock, a drift, a fly, a wing, a cork, a quail, oh. The promise of spring and the riverbank talks of the waters of March. It's the promise of life, it's the joy in your heart. And the riverbank talks of the waters of March. It's the promise of life, it's the joy in your heart. Stroke of night, a pin, a needle, a sting, a pain, a snail, a riddle, a wasp, a stain, hey. A snake, a stick, it is Joe, a fish, a flash, a silvery glow, the bed of the well, the end of the line, a dismay on the face, it's a loss, it's a find, a spear, a spike, a point, a nail, a drip, 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 a drop, the end of the day, and the river bank talks of the waters of March. In your heart, in your heart. The riverbank talks of the waters of heart. It's the promise of life, it's the joy in your heart. quarters of March. It's the promise of life, it's the joy in your heart. The waters of March.